Hello dear, today I am going to demonstrate you a Zoom for laptop and desktop. Using Zoom on desktop laptop is really a good experience. By using Zoom on your laptop or desktop, you can share your presentations, your video more easy and effectively with your clients or your student that may impress your clients or a students with your work. By using its share mode that is present in Zoom app. Let's start how we install Zoom on our laptop. To install Zoom on our laptop, you have to open Chrome and then open Google and then type Zoom app. Now the results, these are the results. You have to use any one of the link to install Zoom meeting app. Suppose I click on this particular link. Now from this particular link, you have to download the Zoom app. And after downloading Zoom app, you have to install it on your PC. I have already installed to save the time. Now, this is the Zoom app. After installing, this is the interface that on your laptop. Now to join the Zoom, you have two options. One is as a student or as a client. Another one is as a teacher or as a boss. In case you have to conduct a meeting, or you to organize a lecture, you must sign into the Zoom app. Or if you are a student or if you are a client, you have to join a particular meeting, you need not to sign into the Zoom account. You have to just click on the join meeting. Then you have to fill meeting ID. This is the name of particular PC, and then after joining this particular things, you have to fill a meeting password that is provided by your senior ones. This is the way that you can easily join. But I can explain this part point of view after explaining you the join as a professor or as a boss. Now to join as a professor, you have to sign this particular one. These are the various options. By using any one of these options, you can sign into the Google Zoom account, or there is also option of sign up free. I prefer to sign in with my Google account you just go one or two steps and you automatically sign in into this particular account. Now this is open Zoom meeting. Now this is the link that comes on your screen after you join in. Now there are four different choices. One is to join the meeting that already discussed. One is to share the screen. One is to schedule. Schedule is there to fix a particular schedule of your meeting, of your conference, of your lecture, so that you prior explain to the nearest one about your schedule. Now this is the new meeting. Click on this new meeting. Now this is the meeting option for that particular things. Now once it is joined on the meeting, you have to set join icon meeting. Now first, this is the option. Either you have to share your video or you have to not share your video first. This is the way that you just off your video. Now this is the next option for mute your voice or anything or not. Now there are something another option. That is one is manage participant. In case of manage participant, you click on that. Now this is the option by which you invite your students, your colleagues to attend the meetings by giving them a link through which they can join the meeting or using the user ID and password. Now I'll show you how you send this link. So this is the link. You have to copy this particular link. You have to invite either through a contact or through a mail. I prefer to invite through a particular mail. Now this is the joining, this is the joining ID, and this is your password that is clearly shown on that, on it. In now let's say, see, now you can Gmail ID. Now this is the link that you have to send to your nearest one, and this is the user ID and this is password. You just fill the email ID of your nearest one and send it to your students or meetings colleagues or another ones. After sending that particular user ID or user ID password or link, your students and your clients are easily sign in or joined with you on this particular meeting. Now this is the way how you can send invitation to your near ones. Next thing is that is that there is another option of share screen. You can also record your conference, meeting or lecture, or in case you have to inform you about some during your lecture, you may also chat from this particular ID. Means in case you want to inform you a single person or without disturbing other, you just send message to that person by selecting that to separate persons, so everybody or to particular someone else. This is the way you can send message. And another thing is share a screen. Now by click on this particular button, you can easily share a screen. Now on a share screen, your whiteboard, using this whiteboard, you can instruct your students or your colleagues. And by clicking on this particular button, you share this screen of your PC with anybody else. Now this is the shared screen. Now you can type on, now you can click on anything that you run your videos, you run your presentation by clicking on this. Now by using this button, you can easily unshared your screen. I think by demonstrating these particular things so far, you are easily understand how you able to create a meeting with your near ones or clique ones, or you conduct a meeting, you conduct a lecture and so on. Now next part of our lecture is how a student can, now by this way you can end the meeting. Now the next part is how a next student can join the meeting. Now I'll explain you in brief how the next one can join the meeting. Now for a join and student can join a meeting, he have to click on the join button, then he have to fill the ID that you send through mail, and then after filling this particular ID, then he have to fill user ID and password and able to join the particular meeting. With these words, I think you are more easily and got the points how you create a meeting or join a meeting using the desktop. Thank you.